My name is Gemma Sandberg, and I've been coming to Sailorville Church since June 2015 with my husband Frederick and our two sons. And today I'm wearing my little shamrock because I am an Irish girl, although I've been living in the US for 9 years and absolutely love Iowa and feel so blessed that God has placed us in Sailorville Church. When I was asked to do Sailorville Stories, it really hit me just how much my story is about two very different lives. My first life lasted for 37 years. I came from a very loving home in Ireland, and I had a successful adult life. But the whole time, my soul was so troubled and lost because I experienced sexual abuse from an uncle from a young age all throughout my childhood. And this forged in me a very pessimistic worldview and deeply affected how I seen myself. During teens and early 20s, I felt completely alienated with the Catholic Church in which I was raised, and I ended up scorning anything to do with Jesus and the Bible. So I lived my adult life as seemed best to me, the whole time carrying the heavy burden of my past experiences, the anxiety, the fear, and the darkness about life. After the birth of our first son, I became curious about God again, and soon I became preoccupied with looking for evidence that he could exist. I searched high and low, reading about all sorts of religious systems, and we attended many different churches. Just after Christmas 2014, one day when I was minding my own business, the words came to me, "What about Jesus? Don't you want to know him?" And this was a ridiculous thought to me at the time. But over the next 6 months, I noticed other things around me calling me to reconsider Christianity. And with his perfect timing and providence, God placed me in Pastor Pat's Bath. And we attended Sailorville Church for 2 Sundays. Then, on the evening of the 30th of June, 2015, my first life closed down for good, and my new life began in Christ. I had just finished an honest and intense phone call with Pastor Pat, and I sat down at my kitchen table and started to write about my life. And what poured out was just how much my soul was grieved that God would allow me to be hurt as a child. I was ranting about all the sin in the world, only to have the Holy Spirit convict me of my sinful ways. I understood then that I needed Jesus to cleanse me just as much as my uncle needed him. At that moment of realization, I felt Jesus speak into my heart many beautiful things. He told me that he died for me, and he asked me to come to him. And I said, through tears of joy, "I come to you running." I felt reconciled to God, but I had never come across 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 19. That evening was the sweetest and most fulfilling experience I have ever had. The evening that I accepted him as Lord and Savior, he took away all the pain and shame about the sexual abuse, so that I can now talk freely about it. And once I read the Gospels and the Book of Hebrews for myself, I realized just how much Jesus, our great high priest, does understand our times of suffering and humiliation because of what he endured. What blows me away is that we don't have some indifferent spectator God. We have a God who's rolled up his sleeves, who's come down in our muck and mire to rescue us, and can truly empathize with anything we may go through because he's gone through worse, and all for love. And when I remember his love and generosity to me, it is a lot easier for me to be generous to others and forgive them their offenses. The night that I understood what Jesus did for me personally, when he shone his light into my heart, I was able to forgive my uncle in a heartbeat because Jesus gave me new eyes to see. And with these new eyes I have, I can now look back on my old life, and I regard it all to be training. I can appreciate that my first life is now serving my second life and all to the glory of God.